All right. Took care of a lot of stuff on the iPad. Dealt with a lot of that stupidness. But now, if you're stuck in a rainy day, how do you make a fire? I'm gonna show you. We got the two best knives here. Case for this, Case Double X Modified, and the Mora Bushcraft. First up, first thing you do, split down the wood. That way you get the dry stuff on the, that way you get to the dry stuff on the inside. And I'm splitting it down pretty far, but you don't have to split it down this far. Rain coming down a bit, or it's just the drops from the stupid thing. Of course, this isn't the only method. I'm gonna have to split it down more. There we go, we got a nice thin spot. I should use the Mora. Small stuff like this, you could use the Mora. Split it. That's not too many right now, but we're gonna keep going. I'm actually gonna make some kindling for this, because now this isn't where I usually make fire, but this is really good. This really does show well why a big knife and a small knife work well together. We're really just making a small fire, so. And because it's wet out, I'm gonna try to use as many advantages as I can. Kindling. Another advantage we need is more feathers. Did I really expect a Mora not to make some really nice feathers? Look at those nice feathers. That's what you can expect from a Mora. Links will be in the description, of course. I'm gonna split it down more, get some feathers with the case. That was rotted. Yeah, it's not gonna get me any more feathers. Slight convex, I gave this from sharpening by accident. Convex thing was accidental. But it makes thin, but it does make flatter feather sticks, if not just a little wider. As I said, since it's wet, we're going to go with as many advantages as we can. A lot of ants here, hang on. This is a big old piece of fat, what I'm going to split down. Gunk, we'll have to clean that off. Not a fat wood dust. This stuff works even in the rain. Now for kindling, we got the fat wood underneath so everything can burn upward. You can hear that rain. But, as you can see, rain is no problem. Thumbnail. That might be a good thumbnail. Actually, I'm going to show something else. That grass is really wet. So, where is it? Where's that piece I had? The smaller one? Shoot. Oh, here we go. Break it off.
This grass is super wet. I just want to show that fatwood works
even when wet. There's no shenanigans here. That's going to keep burning to the side. It's actually burning really well. There's no shenanigans here. This is the wet fatwood. We're going to show just how well it works. Clear this off, no funny business. You saw I got this stuff pretty wet. I just dragged it around through the wet grass. Place your bets if it'll work. Hang on. Place your bets. Most definitely it will. And we got some wet feathers down here. These are soaked. We're gonna try something. This fatwood's gonna burn for quite a while. Theoretically, this could actually light these up. In theory, if it would stay still. Okay, I think we got it stable. In theory, this could work. It's charring it a bit, and we're getting a lot of smoke or steam. Almost. Once again, it's better to go for drier stuff, so hang on. Well, that is thoroughly soaked, except these parts here. Well, that went out before it. How much smoke you're getting here. But now, we're going to do this again, just to show you. I think I just want to use the mora for this, see if I can. Another thing you can do is stuff like this. This isn't fat wood. That's the benefit of a 90-degree spine. Theoretically, this stuff could light up as well. We're gonna give it a try. Yep, there we go. So can you make fire on a rainy day or a wet day? Yes. Is it easy? Not usually, but it can be. I want to try just seeing if I can with just the feathers. We need some nice thin ones first. Now, also, I should mention that this Case XX has a modified spine so it can strike a ferro rod. That's what we're working with. We're going to try without fatwood. If we can't, we'll just use it. Okay, I don't think I bunched them up enough. Hang on. Almost. Up. Almost. Let's try getting some more feathers. We're on the right track. That's what we got to work with. I see a little flame. Oh, it went out. Never mind. We're going to use the scrapings this time. We're going to get fire up with no fatwood. This ain't fatwood, so. You're gonna get it, don't worry. I usually have a hard enough time with this, but since it's wet. Never give up. Never give up. That's right. Never give up. Just clean that off. off because there's gunk all over it. Anyway. That did it. I'm going to try doing that with the Mora. Just to show that both these knives can. Before I get these off the stump, I'm going to stamp out the embers. Everything's wet, but still, better safe than sorry. This might be too wet. In theory, we should be able to. We're going to try it. Steam level's running low, but I'm gonna try to keep going. Almost. I'm getting it, but I'm messing it up. Almost got it that time. Remember what I said earlier? Never give up. Never give up. You're a fucking quitter. Again, I have a hard enough time without the rain. But like I said, never give up. Yeah, I think that sucker went out. I'm gonna get a little fire going here, don't worry. This is a good chance to, this is a fantastic opportunity to show batoning with the Mora. Light batoning is something this Mora can take. That part's too wet. That's the motto for this video right now. Never give up. most. Accidentally messed it up. But you know what? We're gonna end this off with a larger one here. I'm gonna show you. So this might be the bear carver, but that one's the bear scraper. This is another combo from me. We're going to show you why they work well together. Shoot. Almost had it. That's what I said. Never give up. Sometimes you gotta help it along. But this time, I know I said never. This doesn't count as giving up. This is using resources you have at your disposal. That is something only a fool wouldn't do. Might be the first time I scream on camera. If it is, never give up. Next, I would issue this little challenge. If you have a channel that does stuff like this, try something like this. Make as many small little fires as you can in the rain, with and without fat wood or other natural accelerants, and just flint fire steel. No lighters, no matches, just fire steel. I issue that challenge. Now, I may sound hard-edged right now, but at the same time, what you want to do with a fire, you nurture it. Why do you think they say fires die? That's one way to think about it. We're gonna get the sucker up and running. Now, I know this can be frustrating. Trust me, I've been frustrated. I've been frustrated during this video, but the mantra for this video, never give up. mantra for this video has been never give up, hasn't it? Oh, that might have been it. Well, I accidentally put it out. But watch this. Since I have an abundance of fat wood, if I can find a stupid thing up, I'm standing on it. What we're gonna do. I'm gonna show you just how good this stuff is. You can find it naturally. You can buy it. And if you take part in that challenge, this will surely help you along the way. Making some kindling. We're gonna make an all fat wood fire. Now. Just to show you how good this stuff actually is. So that is the challenge I'm issuing. Make a fire in these wet conditions. Use fat wood if you need. If you want a little extra challenge, make one without fat wood. Fire with a fire steel. Other than that, hope you enjoyed this video. No lighters in that. No lighters or matches in this challenge. Just a fire steel. This is going to burn for a while, so I'm going to try to put it out. But, thanks for watching.